Well, happy Monday to you here at 6 o'clock. Alicia Lewis alongside Guy Brown, who's been rocking his winter coat all morning long just to show you how cold it is today. There's another reason, but we want
to stick around.
He'll tell us at the very end of the show.
Yeah, it could be maybe I spilled something all
maybe
over
Maybe he's
my
got a big
shirt.
Stain. We don't really know.
Stain. I don't know. But what I do know is it's going to be cold.
You need the winter coat.
Yeah, you do need that. It's going to be teens and 20s for the wind chill values throughout the day. You can see this map here showing your wind chills, teens, 20s, even though air temperatures today will make it to the upper 30s. So it won't feel like it due to this wind you can see coming out of the northwest. Today, 5 to 15 miles per hour. So here is your current temps waking up this morning in the metro, 20s and 30s. And tomorrow morning is going to be even colder. So I got that breakdown and that 7-day forecast coming up. Alicia?
Taste of winter. All right, Guy, thank you. 6:01 on this Monday. No crashes to report. Drive times average and a live look. The roads around MSP International, 62 at 43rd Avenue, where traffic is pretty quiet this morning. We are following breaking news out of Minneapolis. One person is dead after a shooting on a busy stretch of up in Uptown. Now, it happened near Lagoon and Fremont, and that's right by the Target on Fremont and the Uptown Cub. So here's what we know so far. Officers were called to a shooting near Lagoon and Fremont just before midnight Sunday. Arriving officers found a man shot near the back of a business. First responders tried to save him, but he died before medics could arrive. Right now, investigators are still looking for whoever pulled the trigger. This is the 71st homicide in Minneapolis this year. And this story will be developing all day, so be sure to stay with Care 11 for the very latest. You can check care11.com for any updates on our social media platforms as well. Right now, one of the busiest travel weeks in Minnesota is kicking off. MEA is this weekend, and MSP Airport is already preparing. CeCe's live at the airport for preparations for the very long weekend. Hey, CeCe.
At MSP, we've seen a few school groups ready to board some flights, so I'm sure they're starting their MEA weekend a little bit early. But we're actually told that MEA travel weekend ranks right up there with Thanksgiving and Christmas. So come the end of the week, it's going to be a lot busier here at MSP. MSP will release more information about what you can expect later on in the week here. But demand for travel continues to go up after more than 2 years of the pandemic affecting plans. The travel booking site Hopper projects that pent-up holiday travel demand, along with the jet fuel prices and fewer flights, will drive holiday airfare to its highest in the last 5 years. Thanksgiving airfare prices are up 25% from last year. That's averaging about $281 round trip. That's according to an NBC report. Meanwhile, Christmas travel airfare prices are averaging about $435 round trip, which is up 55% from last year. But experts say these higher prices aren't scaring off customers.
What we've seen so far this year is, despite inflation, people are still choosing to travel. And this is because there's this pent-up demand. We haven't been able to travel the last couple of years. And so there's a little bit more money that's been saved potentially, but also people are choosing to find room in their budget other ways.
AAA says about half of Minnesota travelers plan to take at least one flight this holiday season. So because of that, coming up in about 30 minutes, we're going to give you some tips on booking flights if you haven't done that yet, how to save some money. Alicia.
Oh, good advice. All right, we'll check back soon. CeCe Gaines reporting live at MSP Airport for us. Thank you. And hey, if driving is more your thing, you're going to want to fill up very soon. We just checked the price of a gallon of regular just a few hours ago. You're going to be paying about $3.75 a gallon in Minneapolis. That's actually down from the same time last week as international oil prices are tumbling. Over the border in Wisconsin, you'll pay the same on average, $3.75 a gallon, and that's way down from close to $4 just last week. And we're almost 3 weeks out from Election Day in Minnesota, and the clock is ticking for you to register to vote. If you want to cast a ballot on November 8th, you must be registered by the end of the day tomorrow. You can register online, in person, at an elections office, or have it mailed to you. If you don't make it by then, you can actually register at your polling place on Election Day. And tomorrow, you'll also be able to see Governor Walz and his Republican challenger, Dr. Scott Jensen, duke it out on the debate stage for the second time this election cycle. It's happening at KTTC in Rochester and is hosted by Gray Television Stations. It's not going to air on TV in the Twin Cities, but you can stream it online tomorrow at 8 p.m. Walls and Jensen, they first debated at FarmFest, you might remember, back in August. They're going to face off one final time next week before Election Day. And you can get everything you need to know about Election Day sent right to your cell phone. All you have to do is text the word VOTE to 763-797-7215, and we'll text back with our voters' toolkit. Remember, it's a text-only number. If you're paying off student loans, the application process to have your student loans partially forgiven is now open, and it's through a beta testing period. So applications won't be processed until the website officially opens. Those who apply during this beta phase won't need to reapply. This comes as the Department of Education is facing several lawsuits challenging the policy. Now, some borrowers are left wondering if any money forgiven would be considered taxable income by the state.
In those states, you'll have a tax burden that's typically going to be the equivalent of a few months' payments. Now, some of those states are trying to change their laws to make it tax-free.
This formal application period runs through the end of 2023. It's also important to note that student loan payments have been paused since 2020, but they are set to resume come January. This morning, Minnehaha Falls' biggest attraction is just down to a trickle. Right now, state leaders want to limit water because a drought, it is just so bad right now. And Guy, you're taking a closer look at the latest drought monitor, and it's not easing up anytime soon, unfortunately.
No, yeah, and this is something that we're going to have to monitor through the end of next year and even the next season as well. You can see extreme drought conditions over central Minnesota and especially here for the Twin Cities Metro. Extreme drought conditions, and if you remember this time last year, at least we had made progress because we were dealing with exceptional drought conditions last year this time, but at least we had made progress by this time, at least as we got into the fall season, that is. So something to still stay on top of here. You still got extreme drought conditions from the Twin Cities to Chaska and Belle Plaine, all still seeing those drought conditions continue. And in my 7-day forecast, it looks like a dry one as well. So I don't have any rain, significant chances for that, little to no chances, at least for this week. Alicia.
All right, Guy, thanks. We'll check back in a bit with you.